Thank you, Professor Goldenberg. Very pleasure to be here, ladies and gentlemen. The use of a biofuel is growing around the world, and the debate between biofuel supporters and opponents is intensifying in the last year. Given the rapidly increasing demand for energy, which is projected to double in the mid of this century, is expected that the biofuel will become an important part of the global energy mix and make a significant contribution to meeting energy demand. The main challenge for the future is develop biofuel which is not compete with the food chain, which are sustainable and efficient both in terms of cost of energy and for which the carbon footprint is a net gain. The presentation that I made describes an overview of second generation innovative biofuel plant by energy chain shown are biodiesel, bioethanol from lignocellulosic biomass, which are not in competition with the food crops. And also biomethane is also a very interesting opportunity as fuel thanks to the new hydrate calatrate technologies. It's possible a safety economical storage and ship transport in containers as competitive alternative way to cryogenic technology. This is our headquarter in Perugia, which is the Italian Biomass Research Center, and this is the scenario where we are in Italy, in the middle of Italy. Perugia is located between Rome to Florence. As you will see, the bioenergy in renewable energy in Europe play a strategic role from now to 2030. Now 60% of energy, renewable energy, is from bioenergy, and also in the future, even the growing of renewable energy is reach up to 45%. Bioenergy play a strategic role too in the future. They share about 45-50%. Biofuel, usually first generation, we define as biofuel made from sugar, starch, vegetable oil or animal fat using conventional technology. Second generation biofuel are biofuel producer with process can use a variety of no food crops to avoid conflict with foods. These include waste biomass, straw, wood and special energy biomass crop growing in contaminated or marginal land with or very low water footprint. And third generation are biofuel made from crops which require further research and development to become commercial feasibly, such as perennial grass, fat growing tree and algae. First generation biofuel in Italy is the potential about more than 2 million tons per year in 16 plants for biodiesel and about 210 tons a year, very few, in two plants for bioethanol. But second generation will very promising in the future for two different paths, biochemical path and thermochemical path. Bioethanol through cellulose hydrolysis enzymatic conversion to sugar and then fermentation sugar to ethanol is the first path, and the second one is biodiesel through gasification and Fischer-Tropsch synthesis in order to obtain high quality biodiesel.
you can see here the energy balance comparison between biofuel first and second generation is evident, as the second generation biofuel is more convenient than the first one. Also, biomethane is an interesting chain. It's possible upgrade biogas to biomethane in order to transport or inject in the natural grid, gas grid, and obtain the combined heat and power generation for more efficiency utilization. The next. Sorry, didn't work. I don't know why. Okay. In the bio project, in the project BioDE2 second generation, generation of biodiesel is made from gasification and gasification and synthesis Fischer-Tropsch. One of the most important second generation biodiesel plant is in Koren in Germany, in Freiburg. An important characteristic of produced biodiesel with this technology is the clearness and absence of paraffin, a very high performance. The CRB prototype is under construction near the new laboratory. The Fischer-Tropsch plant has been completed and the first experimentation is started. The system consists of a syngas heating system and Fischer-Tropsch reactor and the tank of biodiesel collection and for the condensation is on component. Here, the Fischer-Tropsch system test with different syngas composition produces some quantity of biodiesel as shown in this slide. The second bioenergy chain is generator bioethanol by biochemical path. And we produce both ethanol and lignin, which is interesting for power and co-firing with the coal. This is our scheme of a power plant in our laboratory that we'll install in the next month. But we use some different crops to supply this chain. This is a cardon, which is a crops growing in land, marginal land without water. And they produce also vegetable oil, about 500 liters per hectare, and they produce lignocellulosic biomass, about 15 tons per hectare. And this is Arundo Donax, which is like canna, but no sugar canna. And also this is Miscanthus, and this is harvesting and rhizomes for Miscanthus. This is a picture, you can see the lignin, which is maybe substitution of coal. The third bioenergy chain describe an innovative technology for biomethane production for transportation or combined heat and power. Look at this picture, you can see the production of biomethane from anaerobic digester from biogas and upgrading to biomethane, an inlet in the natural gas grid in order to obtain natural gas near the utilizer and producing in cogeneration combined heat and power in order to improve efficiency two times respect to normal application. This is some example of a scrubber or membrane to upgrade the biogas to biomethane in order to improve the percentage of biomethane up to 95%. And also another possibility that we are testing is the solar or wind gas production from photovoltaic and electrolysis water and synthesis with the Sabatier process with the CO2 stored part and in order to obtain solar methane or wind methane, wind gas, it depends on when the energy comes through. This methane could be stored and transported to utilize for combined heat and power. We are developing a new technology for storing and transport biomethane by means of hydrate pellet. Hydrate pellet is a nanotechnology. We can close one molecule of methane inside of four molecules of water in order to don't have a pressure and transport with containers insulating from temperature outside at the temperature between minus 10 plus 5 degrees, the hydrate are stable and you can transport and storing about for each container you can transport 10,000 cubic meter of methane. This is important because it's a safety way to transport and storing and supply heat and power system, combined heat and power system. We show you our reactor for producing hydrate, which is the more bigger in Europe, and we can produce biomethane hydrate, for instance, also in a small power plant. And we can produce many of these reactors for each power plant, for each biomethane. And this is a completely chain, starting from producing to utilizer, which can transport also by ship, inside a ship or inside of containers, maybe from Brazil to Italy or maybe from Africa to Italy or Europe. We can transport with this way molecular water in safety and a very cheap economical system without cryogenic system, which are very expensive in and difficult to make for authorization for diciamo very expensive system. In conclusion, the increase of biofuel production is possible if biofuel do not compete with the food chain. use crop no food, use marginal land. Several commercial technology will be ready in the next future to produce, store and transport economical and energy competitive, not only liquid second generation biofuel or first generation biofuel as bioethanol, but also gaseous biofuel such as biomethane from biogas or syngas methane from photovoltaic hydrogen and CO2 conversion. Country seeking to develop a domestic biofuel industry and technology like Italy will be able to play an important role for countries as Brazil, Europe, Union and Africa. Thank you so much.